said it was coming as you are.
David Grant, acting assistant CSP.
This was recorded from the aircraft shortly after the bombing.
This is Altar. I have a message for the American president. The London bombing will have indicated the strength of my resolve. I am in control of Flight 343. This aircraft and its passengers shall remain in my custody until Abu Yafa, criminally held against his will, is released from captivity. My instructions are to be followed precisely. No theater, no negotiation. El Said Yafa will be released and taken to Gatwick Airport, where a private jet will be given clearance to land, then allowed to leave with him. Upon the release of our leader, Flight 343 will continue on to Washington, where half the passengers will be exchanged for fuel and 50 million in gold bullion. Abu Yafa must be airborne and in communication with me by 6 a.m. Greenwich, or the citizens of London will suffer another punishment on your behalf that will make today's bombing pale in comparison.
Mr. Grant, this man, Altar, who is he?
Voice print analysis confirms that it's Naji Hassan, Yafa's deputy director. He's an extremist in every sense, taken completely at his word. He's not bluffing. But in my opinion...
Thank you. Any other comments?
Well, it seems that our first posture must be one of containment.
You mean acquiesce to Naji's demand?
I don't say the president has any other choice. London is demanding immediate action.
I agree. I hate the idea of conceding anything to that bastard, but we have to get him on the ground. Then we have some options.
Colonel Travis and his team will be ready to respond once the plane is at Dulles. It means shutting it down, rerouting all traffic, a full military control of the entire area.
Secretary White, excuse me. Gentlemen, I don't believe we can allow that plane to land at Dulles or even enter U.S. airspace.
What are you talking about?
Well, sir, I don't think this is about hostages. I think it's about one man planning a major strike against the United States.
I think you better explain yourself, Mr. Grant.
Our research leads me to believe that due to his own internal political situation, it was Naji Hassan himself who orchestrated Yafa's abduction.
Come on.
6 months ago, a shipment of the nerve toxin DZ5 was hijacked while in transit from Russia to Germany. Now, we're certain the Chechen mafia was behind the hijacking. But unfortunately, recent attempts to recover the nerve gas had failed. A few days ago, rumors surfaced that the DZ5 was now in the hands of an Osmed Rashami.
Covert operator sent us on a wild goose chase. The Middle East.
A known supplier of arms and explosives to Yafa's group.
Mr. Grant. Are you saying the nerve gas is on board?
Yes, sir, I am. And it's my opinion that Hassan is planning to use the DZ-5 and the airplane together as a tactical weapon, a sort of poor man's atomic bomb to be detonated here, over Washington.
How much of this DZ-5 might he have?
I can't be exact there, sir, but I can tell you this much. If this were DZ-5, that single drop would be more than enough to kill every man in this room. And by the way, the name he's using, Altar, in ancient Arabic means revenge.